So out of nowhere, this thing just kind of showed up. This is the Skyrover X1, a completely new drone trying to break into the sub 250 gram drone category, which is honestly pretty competitive, especially with everyone trying to find a solid DJI alternative drone in the United States. And yeah, when Skyrover first reached out to me, I was honestly pretty hesitant because I've never heard of them before. And it feels like they just kind of materialized overnight, which is odd. But after actually getting it into the air, I was honestly surprised at how thought out this little drone is. So yeah, this is just gonna be kind of a first impression look at the Skyrover X1 and exploring whether or not it is a actually competent sub 250 gram drone that you can buy on Amazon right now. Now, before we get too far into this, let's go ahead and start with the build quality and design of this thing. I will say that it looks very familiar and it's extremely lightweight, being under 250 grams. Now, the advantage of it being under 250 grams is it requires a lot less regulation and training to be able to operate in a lot of countries. And that's honestly really great for beginner flyers or even people who just want to be content creators. But I actually really enjoy, as funny as it is, the yellow design, specifically because if you've ever flown drones before, they'd be really hard to see in the sky. And yellow contrasts really, really well with a blue sky. So this thing is a lot easier to see and a lot harder to lose in the sky. Other than that, it's, you know, in order to be this lightweight, it is a plastic build. There's nothing too fancy about that, but yeah, it's nice. And as far as the controller goes, because I am a stickler when it comes to the controllers, old drone controls were kind of whatever. This is really nice. The stick tension is good for when you're actually controlling the drone. Basically, it means that if you're trying to do slow, fine-tune movements, you can do that pretty easily with this. The only thing for me as a critique is that on the back, you have a little dial here to be able to tilt up and down. I think it's a little more sensitive than I would like, but I do think that that is something that they could tune in a firmware update, because again, this is a very new drone to the market. Additional things on the controller is you do have a cine, normal, and sport mode, which is really great. Sport mode is if you just want to turn off obstacle avoidance and rip it if you're chasing after a car or something like that. Normal if you're kind of doing a mixture, and then cine if you want to get those really beautiful, really slow cinematic shots, which is probably the mode that I leave it in the most. Now for me, one of the more important features of a drone is definitely going to be how portable it is. And of course, this one is extremely portable, being that it can collapse down. And again, it is very lightweight, but look at this thing. I mean, it's, you know, it really doesn't take up too much space at all. So being able to toss this in my backpack as I travel around is a pretty big advantage. So let's go ahead and discuss image quality when it comes to the Skyrover X1. Now, it is capable of recording up to 4K 60 frames per second, which is pretty dang good, actually. That being said, one of the things that I've noticed is that you can only film in either their standard picture profile or HLG. You can't actually film in log. That's kind of a bummer, but I will say that the image quality does look pretty dang good without it, for whatever that's worth. Hopefully they end up adding log soon. Again, it's a new drone company, so that's almost to be expected. Now, when it comes to the actual live feed, you do get a 1080p live feed up to 15 kilometers away with this thing, which is honestly pretty incredible, especially when you're flying in areas where, you know, there's a lot of stone or concrete around. You want to make sure that your connection is good. That way you don't accidentally lose your drone, which would not be fun at all. Additionally, the Skyrover X1 is supposed to be pretty dang good at night. Obviously, it's really, really bright out right now, but later I'll be flying this at night. So you guys can see right now, how does the footage actually look? And this little sensor is also able to take 8K 48 megapixel photos. So if your plan is to use this thing more as a photography drone rather than a video drone, it's more than capable there. And one of the last things to note about this little drone is that it does actually rotate the camera so that you can do a vertical mode, which is again, a great feature for content creators because we're always having to film for things like TikTok or Instagram. Now, one of the things that got me the most excited about this little drone, because I do see this as more of a beginner level drone, is that it does have a full 360 degrees of obstacle avoidance detection sensors, which is fantastic. I have definitely crashed a drone or two in my day because it didn't have side sensors. That's the one that always gets me. I'm swooping left or right and I end up running into a tree that I didn't quite see. That one really sucks. So having a full 360 degrees of obstacle avoidance is fantastic. And I did go ahead and just fly it at some things to test it to see how good or bad it is. So I put my drone on the line for you guys. Hopefully you can leave me a like at least for that. So one of the most impressive things that I have seen with this drone is the tracking modes or the various different smart features that this drone has. My favorite one that I've been messing around with, honestly, is just the simple orbit mode, because honestly, a lot of drone shots that I personally end up doing is a simple left to right orbit parallax shot. I just find that those look really clean, and this makes it super simple. All you have to do is drag your finger over the subject that you want to track. It automatically detects what it is, and then you just tell it that I want to go left or I want to go right, and at what speed you end up wanting to do that at. And I find that it honestly does a wonderful job of keeping the subject in the middle of your frame and also making sure that the movement is very smooth. Also, a car was actually driving by just a minute ago and I thought I should go ahead and try the follow mode. So I just quickly swiped over the car. It automatically detected it. In fact, it detected that it was a car specifically. And then I clicked the follow mode and it simply tracked along with it. And I didn't even have to do anything. I think that these smart AI features are really well implemented into SkyRover's UI. And just for fun, I'm going to go ahead and do a live demo for you guys here. So I'm gonna fly this thing down. We're going to track me. And I'm just going to click on active track, hit record. And now as I walk, the drone's actually going to track along with me, which is honestly pretty sick. And I think I can actually still control it if I want to. I can. So I can orbit around me if I want and go this way and then walk back this way. And the drone is just going to simply track along with me and I don't have to do anything. Now, honestly, one of the more important things when it comes to having a drone that you kind of want to travel with, that's, I feel like, where this drone is going to be particularly useful, you want the battery life to be pretty good. So from personally my testing, I have found that ripping this thing around in various different modes and just kind of a normal, I don't know, it's like 65 degrees today, nothing too fancy, I found that one battery was giving me between 25-ish to maybe 30-ish minutes per battery. So I have about an hour and a half with their fly combo that they offer, which is pretty great, which I do think is honestly plenty. I personally normally am doing a particular shot when it comes to a drone. I'm not just kind of flying around all willy-nilly. Now, if I am in a particularly beautiful environment, I do like to fly around a lot and get a lot of different footage, but I do think, especially with a couple different batteries, you're gonna have plenty of time in the air with the SkyRover X1. Now, it's not as flashy as talking about the drone itself, but I do think that talking about the app UI is pretty important because it's a large experience of actually flying a drone. And personally, I found this to be very familiar feeling and very intuitive, which are both really good. Additionally, the first time I booted this thing up, it did ask me if I wanted to go through a flight tutorial, and it actually told you what the different joysticks do and stuff like that, and made sure that you actually knew how to fly it before you really got out there and ripped it around, which I think is actually a great addition. Other than that, the camera settings and everything are really easy to find. You have all your basic camera settings at the bottom right once you switch it into the pro mode, which is pretty simple. And additionally, if you want to quickly switch between your landscape content to shooting vertical content, you can simply click on the button right there on the main display. If you want to go into tracking, you just swipe your finger over whatever you want. Personally, I have found SkyRover's app UI to be honestly fairly robust and, again, very familiar. So after really getting a chance to mess around with the SkyRover X1, I can honestly say that it is a very competent, compact, lightweight drone. And I think the thing that impressed me the most about this drone in particular is just how robust their UI seems to be, as well as their AI tracking features. I do find that this drone is extremely beginner friendly, which for me is a big deal. Honestly though, image quality actually looks really good, so I'm gonna have no problem keeping this thing in my bag anytime I travel in Neen drone footage for myself. Now, this is a little bit time sensitive, but Black Friday is coming up, and I did notice that on Amazon, the SkyRover X1 is pretty massively on sale. So if you've been keeping your eye on this drone, or this is something you've been interested in picking up for yourself, I'll have a link in the description that will take you to the Amazon page so that you guys can get a pretty great discount on this awesome drone. I really wasn't expecting to like this drone so much, especially having never heard of SkyRover, but again, I am genuinely impressed. Hopefully you all are as well. If you enjoyed this video, I really do appreciate if you leave me a like. It does help out the channel a lot, and I greatly appreciate it. I hope that you all have a fantastic week. I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy, guys.